Having a coach can change your business. It certainly changed mine. Hi, I'm Stephen Lingley, a broker associate with Premier Sotheby's International Realty in Venice, Florida. Let's take 5 minutes to talk about selecting a coach and the top three things I implemented after hiring one. Hiring a coach is very personal. Just because one coach worked for the top producer in your office doesn't mean that coach will work for you. When I started researching coaches, that was 10 years ago. Now I've implemented numerous programs and strategies that have changed the way I do business. Our first task was to develop a one-year business plan based on my income objectives. Using data from previous listings, such as average sales price, the number of listing versus buyer side transactions and earned commission, we determined the number of prospecting calls and listing appointments needed in order to obtain the listings. We also defined the listing inventory in terms of average list price, average sales price. We developed a plan for the entire year, then broke it down to quarterly, monthly, weekly, and ultimately daily objectives so I knew how many calls I needed to make in any given day. My prospecting routine includes reaching out to for sale by owners, expired listings, family, friends, and previous customers. My coach helped me identify how much time and effort I should spend with each target audience for the most effective and efficient outcome. Accounting software helps me track every dollar of income and every expense, which helped me determine how much of my income to allocate to marketing. During weekly conference calls, my coach and I reviewed my progress and adjusted our revenue strategies accordingly. With a solid business plan in place, my coach and I turned our attention to contact management systems. There are many options, and I tried several geared towards the real estate profession. I selected Microsoft Office because it offers everything I need in terms of features. With this system, I can capture, manage, and track my communications, export data to Excel or Access, and use Outlook for email, task management, and other great features. Most importantly, it enables me to share contact information quickly and easily with home inspectors, insurance agents, surveyors, attorneys, and others outside of our profession who play a significant role in a transaction. My coach was also instrumental in developing a marketing program that suits my work style, schedule, and personality. Using a variety of strategies, I'm able to keep the listing pipeline full even when inventory levels were low. Here's how I do it. First, I send monthly direct mail pieces targeted to clients in farming areas whose homes and therefore potential sale price will achieve my income goals. I use the same format each month for consistency, so when a prospect receives a direct mail promotion, they know it's from me. I love to entertain, so once a month I host a meet and greet at a homeowners association or condo association. It is open to all homeowners and tenants in the community. I supply drinks and appetizers. My goal is to get to know people in the community, not necessarily to talk about real estate. Of course, if they need a realtor, I want them to remember me. Finally, my prospecting plan includes 5 phone calls a day to past customers, current clients, family, friends, and others in my circle of influence. And without fail, I'll receive at least 1 contact follow-up from one of those 5 phone calls. I'm Stephen Lingley, and I hope these tips have inspired you to seriously consider working with a coach to boost your income potential. Take care.